Does dropping salt from your diet lead to weight loss? What's up everyone, this is Roshni Sanghvi. I'm a plant-based sports nutritionist and a body transformation specialist here to help you reach your fittest self. Does dropping salt from your diet lead to weight loss? I remember talking to a client about this, a client who came to my gym. She spoke to me and she said, I've tried everything for weight loss, nothing seems to work. I've even dropped salt from my diet. And my first question to her was, why? Why would you drop salt from your diet? Salt has pretty much no calories. Her reply was that my trainer told me to drop salt from my diet because that's what's causing my weight gain. I called the trainer immediately, obviously, and asked him, what is the logic behind salt and weight loss? His response was that when he was going for a bodybuilding competition, his trainer had suggested him to get off salt for the last 1 week of the competition to help him reduce body water, to help him basically get depleted. And honestly speaking, that makes sense. If you stop having salt in your diet, salt is what retains body water. And if you stop having salt in your diet, your body does not hold on to water any longer. So it does make a marginal difference, but when you're competing. For people who are 80, 90 or even 100 kgs, dropping salt from your diet is not going to make any difference really. And even if it does make a difference, it's just water loss. You're going to gain it back the moment you start having regular food. It's not going to help you in terms of toning down. Let's explore this a little bit more. What is salt? Salt is basically sodium. Sodium, which is very important for the body. Now, what happens when you stop taking sodium? If you stop taking sodium and your sodium level drops in the body, this triggers the adrenal glands to release certain hormones, which tells your kidney to start storing more sodium. It sends a signal to your kidneys and your skin to start storing more sodium and not to get rid of the same through urine. And your kidneys are going to work overtime in terms of trying to hold on to every little bit of sodium you're getting from your diet. This action of the adrenal glands signaling the kidneys and the kidneys working overtime triggers the release of the stress hormone in the body. Your internal stress level starts rising. The hormone cortisol starts rising in the body. Over time, chronic cortisol exposure has been linked with blood pressure, strokes, and weight gain. So what you're trying to temporarily achieve in terms of dropping salt from your diet or sodium from your diet to get rid of a little bit of body water, which probably won't even show on your body, might have long-term consequences on your health overall. So it's a really bad option to drop salt from that perspective. There are a couple of other reasons which we'll explore as we talk through this video. But before that, let's discuss. Haven't we all heard of studies or spoken to doctors who've told you that increasing salt intake will lead to increased blood pressure? That is true. But maybe there's no direct relationship. Let me give you an example. Decreased vitamin D or vitamin D deficiency has been linked with obesity. So if you check yourself and you don't have enough vitamin D, then you probably also are more likely to have obesity. But maybe there's no direct relationship. Your body gets vitamin D or vitamin D starts synthesizing in the body when you expose yourself to sunlight. Now think of people who expose themselves to sunlight. They're more likely to be outdoors. If someone is more likely to be outdoors, they're probably a little more physically active than people staying indoors. Maybe being outdoors and being physically active is the reason they're not obese. Maybe staying indoors, maybe not getting enough sunlight is the reason they are obese. Maybe there's no direct relationship of vitamin D and obesity. Maybe activity level is the middle factor. The same thing goes with salt. Maybe people who consume a high salt diet do have high blood pressure, or high salt consumption leads to higher blood pressure. But people who consume a high salt diet are probably getting their salt from sources like cheese and processed meat. Cheese and processed meat have the highest amount of sodium. 100 grams of cheese has enough salt for pretty much half of your daily intake, which is a lot of salt. And most people who consume processed meat, salt is used to increase the shelf life of processed meat. And if you're consuming a lot of processed meat, maybe that's the reason for higher blood pressure. Maybe salt doesn't have much to do with it. That does not go to say people who have kidney problems or have blood pressure should start taking a lot of salt, but maybe stay away from the French fries. The table salt, the little bit of salt you're adding on your food, makes your food palatable. If your food is palatable, you're more likely to stick to your nutrition plans and not have cravings. What is cravings? If you stop taking sodium or stop taking salt and your body is really demanding it, your body is going to send you signals. You know, and signals are going to come in the form of cravings. You're suddenly going to have cravings for like junk food or like, you know, Burger King and French fries. All of this is very, very high in sodium. Maybe to begin with, if you used a little bit of salt on your food, you probably won't have cravings at all in the first place. What I'm trying to say is, it's not necessary that little bit of salt you're using on your food is leading to blood pressure. But maybe a lot of processed food, processed meat, junk food, things which come in packets which have high sodium has been linked to blood pressure. But now that we know that salt is important for the body, what type of salt should we use? Everyone has this crazy rage about pink salt and sea salt and Himalayan salt, and all of this is marginally good than table salt. When I say marginally, it does have a little bit more calcium, a little bit more iron, a little bit more micronutrients. But when I say little bit, I mean you could eat like half a banana and a few leaves of spinach and get that much amount of micronutrients. But table salt and pink salt, when you compare, pink salt does marginally better. But what's more important to you is not table salt, not pink salt. It's something called iodized salt. If you look at a traditional Indian diet does not have a lot of iodine. You're not getting enough iodine, which is why manufacturers, like salt manufacturers, started adding iodine as a component on salt. So you're getting your daily requirements of iodine. What happens if you don't get enough iodine? If you don't get enough iodine, your thyroid hormone doesn't function properly and you're likely to be diagnosed with hypothyroid. Hypothyroid leads to weight gain, among a lot of other things, and hormonal fluctuations in the body. Now, let's say you switch to pink salt, which doesn't have iodine, and you start consuming pink salt. In a few weeks, you start noticing that you feel lethargy, you're not feeling like doing much, you're feeling low on energy, you start gaining weight, you go to your doctor, and doctor says these are the classic symptoms of hypothyroid and puts you on medication for hypothyroid. Doctors rarely have time to ask you what type of salt are you using. If only you had introduced iodine into your diet, you probably wouldn't have hypothyroid in the first place. Treatment for hypothyroid across the globe starts with introducing iodine into your diet also. Iodine is extremely important for your hormones to function well, for hormonal balance. And one of the sources for humans to get iodine is iodized salt. What are the other sources? You could get iodine from the best source, actually, sea vegetables like kelp and wakame and nori sheets. But most of y'all probably wouldn't have even heard of these. If you're having a sushi meal a few times in a week, you're getting your iodine. We don't. So we're not getting iodine intake, which is why iodized salt is extremely important. Not sea salt, not pink salt, not table salt, not Himalayan salt, not any other kind of salt, but iodized salt. Look at your salt packet, it should say iodized salt. And start introducing a little bit of iodized salt into your diet. Ideally, my suggestion to you is once your food is cooked and served to you on your table, add a little bit of salt on top of it. Salt is important to your body. Your tongue has different sensory receptors. One of the sensory receptors is salty. If you don't give yourself salty food, you're more likely to have cravings for junk. Green leafy vegetables also have a little bit of sodium. Thus, one way to stop junk food craving is introducing green leafy vegetables into your diet because it does have sodium. A good plant-based diet has your daily sodium requirements, but a little bit of iodized salt on top of your food is only going to do you wonders and not going to lead to weight gain. It's really important to understand this. Don't deprive yourself of salt. If anything, make a lifestyle modification, a lifestyle change to introduce iodized salt into your diet. I really hope this video clarifies some doubts for you. And for people really avoiding salt, please pass them this video. Share it with a friend or family who desperately needs to see it. And follow me on social media. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like this video and leave a comment if you have further questions, and I'll be more than glad to help them. This is Roshni Sanghvi. Cheers, guys. Bye.